I'm Her Moments 3. Now, I'm surprised you like this series so much. It's a good thing y'all like to see some more, female representation in anime, seeing like they have great moments just like the guys. But I think this time I'm gonna go above and beyond. See, this time we're gonna switch it up a little bit. It's still gonna be anime. I'm gonna add on some more animated things such as cartoons and maybe some manga. But before I do, go ahead and like the video. Y'all went crazy with likes last time. Do the same for this one. I greatly appreciate it. It helps out a lot. And subscribe if you even want more. Like the video if you want part four, man. I keep it going. I don't know how much more I got me, but I'll find something. With that being said, let's start the video. Oh, whoa. First up, we got, I had to include this one. We got Urza versus 100 Knights. Now, it's from Fairy Tail. Now, I know, shout out to the commenters that have been commenting this so long, but yeah, here we are. Now, the reason I ain't talking about it before, because I haven't got to that arc yet. No, I just got to that arc in Fairy Tail. I haven't got to that moment yet, but I was watching and I finally got to the episode. Man, there was a line, bro. She went nuts, bro. F for 20v1, bro. This is a 100 versus 1, and she went off, bro. She went against 100 knights. These niggas forgot who I am, bro. And that is Urza motherfucking Scarlet, bro. She transformed to like 6 different forms and started slaying them niggas, bro. She is a little tiring, but she got through it. She got that will, bro. She pushed through all that shit and legit started killing them. By the way, the whole Grand Magic Games arc has been actually pretty good. I see why the hype has been, I ain't finished yet, but it is good so far. But damn, Urza, whew, she's a badass female character. Not just anime, a female character, nigga. Simple. On to another badass female anime character, and that is Rukia. If you haven't seen Thousand Year Blower arc, spoilers, of course, because this was Core 2, I think I did a video about this, too. Go watch that video for Core 2. I think I did like half of it. Sorry, I didn't finish it. Sorry, other stuff came up. But hey, shit happens. But in that episode or video, I talked about her Bankai. Now, if you don't know, if you haven't seen Rukia's Bankai, I got spoiled by Jump Force, so I knew, but I was like, oh, I didn't see this in the anime until actually I was in the manga. Thanks a lot, Jump Force, for that. But yeah, but when it finally got animated to the Thousand Year Blood War arc, oh my god, that was the best episode of that core. I don't care what no one say, that was the best. Episode 6, I think, yeah, the best, man. Look how beautiful she is, bro. And the whole fight was great, too, with the help of Byakuya, it was all great. But like just seeing, I think someone said that's the most beautiful Bankai, and that literally is the Ice Queen. I love Rukia so much, and she did it such class too. Oh my god, I love her so much. And she has other moments too, but this one is recent, and plus she looks so damn good, bro. I just know this one episode, when it was trending, everyone was talking about it, at least for Twitter and like Instagram and Reddit. They was all talking about this episode, and it was like, oh my god, this is the best Bleach episode in a long time. Rukia is her. She shook the internet, bro. And yeah, that's my queen Rukia. Next, we got a character from a cartoon, and that is Avatar. Y'all know I'm going this, but I can mention Toph, I can mention Katara, I can mention a whole bunch of other female characters, but I might say that for later. But I know one character that one moment has always stayed with me in Avatar is Azula, the Menace herself. I mentioned her in like my top 20 villains list before. I love her so much. She is ranked very high on that list, by the way. And bro, she is her. Like, just the power. She's gifted. She talks this shit. She can back it up. She, I think she rips some niggas too. just remember that. But one moment where, like, I think in the end of book 2. You already know how powerful the Avatar is. And they got into it like a little bit. I forgot what exactly happened. I just remember the moment, bro, where she, Azula herself, defeated the Avatar, and it was such a killing blow, but she used that lightning shit and boom, struck his ass down. And look at she looking after that. Oh yeah, she know she's her, bro. I just remember that moment. I was like, damn, not the Avatar. And that's low-key when I was like, okay, she is different. And like I said, she just kept getting better but as a character, and I love, her rise and even her downfall. She's such like a greatly written character, but I just remember that moment. I was like, okay, my bad, I've been sleeping on you. You got it. Honestly, it's between like a her and Toph as like a Taz, my favorite female character in that show. Cause Toph is her, like, come on. All right, next up, we gonna switch it up. I know the last three ones like, attacks, fights and moments. Nah, this one is different. Now, this is a female, like I said, I'm her, can mean anything from like a triumphant moment to like showing off her new skills and like proving somebody wrong, outshining somebody, and that is one from Nana, the anime. I've been meaning to talk about this anime for so long. I was supposed to do a video about this a long time ago, but I couldn't. Let me know if y'all still want that. I still might do it anyways, because I love Nana that much. It has great build up to the characters, development, crazy moments, drama. I think I mentioned that already. Music. The music is, oh, S tier. But long story short, I'm gonna give you all the synopsis of this, like not for the show, but like for this, you know, I'm her scenario. So just know that Nana Osaki, I think that's her name, I know. Both the main character's name is Nana, so just the emo Nana, she is part of a band, right? And she moved to a different country, Japan, to start like her new career as a band, you know, as a singing artist, because she could sing her ass off. But her ex, this nigga, Ren, is a part of a band too, but he moved earlier than her to be a part of this major band. Like, they already established, bro. This is like one of the top selling bands in the country and shit. So yeah, so he left her to join that band, and she was like, okay, bet, you gonna leave me? All right, bet, I'm gonna start my own shit too, and then with my own band, and boom. So in the anime, each one of Nana Osaki performance, especially the first one, bro, she is her. She owns it every time. She's so talented. She can sing her ass off. The band helps her too. You know, Nobu is a great rocker. Yasu is a great drummer, and she can sing her ass off. Just a great combination. Look at everyone's reaction, especially, you know, Ren's new band, you know, with the top established people. It was like, oh shit. And even later down the show, like, they end up rivaling each other. That's how you know she's her, bro. Because she wasn't that popping at first, but she kept, you know, performing. She moved out to chase her dreams, and look at her now, competing with the best. But I remember when they was gonna drop their album or something like that, they had like a record deal. The other band was like, okay, they was plotting. It was like, okay, she doing this shit, babe, we need to up our shit. Like, okay, she had the niggas shook, bro. Had them niggas shook. That's how you do it. Not that it's so her, bro. She's such a queen. But yeah, that's one. Just had to switch it up, you know, bring in some, you know, band stuff. And speaking of the band, I got another one too. We got Bochy the Rock. Oh my god. Nah, I used to meme so much throughout these videos that I put on my channel, but yeah, just know Bochy the Rock, if you haven't seen it, it's so good. I think I did a video back in the day too. I did a video on everything, Jesus. But yeah, go watch that. Just know, simply to put, it's about a girl with heavy, heavy bad anxiety, but she finds, you know, a group of girls that she loves, you know, doing band with. And it comes out her share. It's like a coming-of-age story, and it is so funny and so good to watch too. Like, Bochy is literally her, because, man, her first performance with the guys, she was so scared to do it, but she, once she did it, bro, look how she killed that scene, bro. She was, you know, strumming her guitar, and she was killing it, bro. That's what I'm talking about, bro. For her first live performance like that, with in front of a crowd, she did so good, bro. That's one of my favorite episodes of that year that came out, bro. Such a good episode. Bochy is her, and she overcome everything just to do that, and she's just getting started. And that's all I gotta say about that. Bochy will rock your world, so go ahead and watch it. Alright, next we're going back to a cartoon. I love talking about this show. Arcane, bro. And this is 2 years, or probably 3 years old. And I'm so mad. I think I said it before. I'm so mad that I didn't do like a video on Arcane when it came out. It's coming back November this year, or not November, fall this year. I know that for sure. Bro, I'm so excited about that. Holy shit, I can't wait. But I want to talk about Jinx, my favorite character in the show and one of my favorite female characters of all time. She is her, bro. How she was written, her development, what she went through. Now, when I say she's her, especially her skills, she was always good at shooting, like, especially when she was, like, super young. But, bro, when she grew up and became, like, you know, mad, she could not be effed with, bro. The battle she would get in, bro, she had a blicky on her, GG's. I remember when she was like getting attacked with her and her sister. Hold on, anytime she's like getting attacked, if she has a tool with her, oh my god, it's over. She blitzing these guys. I remember one time she shot a guy, like, they was like getting jumped and stuff. She shot her, and then, bro, they tried to hit her. She dodged and then put like a bomb under that little, what was it, the glider thing they had on. And then that shit exploded. Her arsenal is crazy. Her, like, skill, like, her precision is crazy. Her reaction time is crazy. Like, she is different, bro. Oh my god. It's not talked about enough how skillful she is as, like, a fighter in the show. And even the fight with Echo, well, I guess it was a draw, but that was the beautiful showcase. It's usually one of the best fights that came out that year, easily. And yeah, Jinx is her, bro. She's different. And also, I might save V for next video, like probably part 4, whenever I do that one. Because, well, she got hands, man. Alright, last two. We got a fight between two great female characters. Badass female characters. Now, if you haven't seen Fate, yep. Fate, Heavensfield at that. So, if you don't know, Fate Zero is the prequel to Fate series. And then Fate Heavensfield is like the movies. It's 3 movies in one, but that's like a different storytelling of Fate, the series. It's a lot, trust me, but just know in Fate Heavensfield, Ryder as a character is a lot more fleshed out and better written than the one in the Fate series, or at least used more in the movies. And I remember, like, it came to a point in time where she had to protect, I think, Shiru or something like that. And she fought Evil Saber. That's not really her name, but I just call her that because she was evil. I think still to this day, it's a tie between Demon Slayer and the whole Girito and Tengen fight and Tanjiro. And Saber versus Rider in that movie. People say which one is better. I can't tell or decide. But damn, that is easily one of the best animated fights I've seen in anime. I'm talking about, it's like probably top five or three, bro. Rider versus Saber, they went nuts, bro. Look at the animation and look at the skills, the attacks they used. I couldn't tell who was winning, I ain't gonna lie. They went nuts, bro. It just seemed like they had bad blood for each other, bro. Nah, they were just throwing haymakers back to back, you know, heavy attacks. And if you love visually pleasing anime fights, go watch that. And one thing I love about this fight too is it's so unique because that usually you see like great animated fights have like, you know, two males or like a monster and like a fighter and stuff, but I haven't seen that meme that has just straight female characters. Like, I'm talking about female warriors that would just battle to the end, bro, to see which one's strongest and which one win this battle. It was such a great showcase of the characters, and bro, Rider and Saber are her. And I think I mentioned Saber before, but hey, she has more than one moments, bro. And last but not least, we got Black Lagoon character. Now, if you don't know, I've seen this trend recently on TikTok saying that the Black Lagoon cast with female anime characters are like, you know, they would do some crazy things just to be in it, you know. Horny ass niggas, but I agree, man. Just look at them. Ooh! But yeah, Black Lagoon has easily the best anime female cast out there, at least one of the best. It need to be talked about more, but one of the other characters I mentioned Revy last time, this time we got Roberta. Oh my god, bro. You think she's a maid? Hell nah, she's a cold-blooded killer. And I will go over the story of a character, but I want y'all to check it out. But just know it's a great written story. And it definitely goes in a lot in the anime, but the OVA, like, it was a good story in the anime, like the series run. But when the OVA came out and it was about her, shit, I'm talking about she went from like a B plus A minus character to an S tier character in that show. That's how good the OVA was. And go watch it, but like, in the OVA, you see in the episodes that she does some crazy things. Like, bro, she seduced niggas, she killed niggas, even talked the shit a little bit. I just remember her run she had in that, like, in OVA. Like, she went through like 10 different guys, even the other cast, to the point that she was actually scary to fight against. Like, she got niggas shaking, bro. Had niggas, you know, fearing for their life. And that's how the aura, damn, maybe she, like, if I do an aura part 2 in that video, I might talk about more of those scenes and, you know, anime characters in the most aura. I could just say something, but yeah, just know, oh my god, it was unforgettable. One of the best OVAs I watched for a character in it, even in an anime. So yeah, hell, she even fought Revy 1-on-1 and it was an even fight, man. That's all I gotta say, man. I'm cooking up too much for her, bro. But yeah, Roberta is her. Everyone on this list is her. And I love doing these videos. Hope y'all like this one. And I'll probably do an I'm Him moments too, like a part two in that. We'll see. But if y'all want that, comment down below or like the video, of course. And I got y'all in the next one. I am out. Love y'all. Subscribe. Whoa, bye.